cistoda. These are commonly known as the tapeworms. Body is resembles to tape or ribbon leg, hence they are known as the tapeworms. Example is the echinococcus, it is the dwarf tapeworm, and longest tapeworm is Tinea saginata. Hence they are known as the tapeworms. They are endoparasites. Most of the organisms are present inside the alimentary canal of the host. That's why they are known as the endoparasites. His body is externally covered by a syncytial epidermis. Syncytial epidermis is present, many nuclei are present in the epidermal cells, and body's tough tegument is also covered. It gives protection to the body. His body is mainly divided into three parts: scolex and neck, strobila. For example, you can take echinococcus. It's at the anterior region of the body. This region is known as the scolex region. It's in the scolex region. Two rows of hooks are present at the anterior end of the body, and there are four suckers are present. One is the dorsal side, other is the ventral side, and two are lateral sides. They are highly muscular, and with the help of the hooks and suckers, it is attached to the host intestine. And behind that, there is a unsegmented part is present, that is known as the neck. And behind the neck, there are large number of segments are present, which are known as the strobila or segments. Here body is divided into segments, but they are not true segments, they are pseudo metamerism. Already we have discussed that. And reproductive system. Reproductive system, they are hermaphrodites. Both male and female reproductive organs are present. In the same individual, not only one segment, they are present in each and every segment also. Here, the immature segment, here, this is the mature segment, here is the gravid segment. Reproductive organs are degenerated and disappeared, and uterus is branched and filled with a large number of eggs. They are known as the gravid segments. And development is indirect development. Yes, in the life history, larval form is present. This is known as the cysticercus larva. This is also known as bladder worm. Sometimes they require many hosts also. Here, this is echinococcus, is the found in the intestine of dog, hence it is known as the dog tapeworm. Tinea solium. Life history is complete, two hosts. Primary host is the man, intermediate host is the pig. Examples are Tinea solium, Echinococcus dog tapeworm. Yes, these are the main characters of the class Cistoda. Once again, we have to discuss that they are commonly known as the tapeworms, and they are endoparasites, mostly found in the intestine of host, and syncytial epidermis are present, and body is divided into three parts: scolex, neck, and strobila. And strobila, there are different segments are present. They are not true segments. They shows the metamerism, pseudo metamerism, and they are hermaphroditic animals. Both male and female reproductive organs are present. They are highly complicated reproductive organs are present here, and development includes many larval forms also. Here they are cysticercus larvae, which is also known as bladder worm. Examples are Tinea solium, it is known as the pig tapeworm, and echinococcus is the dog tapeworm.